Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to this new playlist where I'm talking about React hooks and the latest features in React. Okay, in this video, let's try to write a simple component using ES6 class. Okay, or using functions, right? We'll try to see what is the main difference, fundamental difference between class-based component and functional component. Because in this playlist, we are more going to talk about the functional component. So when we are actually writing the class-based component, what we are doing is React, we are importing required things. So we are importing and then we are writing class. Either you can directly export this component. Export class hello. Sorry. It will extend the component. Right, this is how we write our classes. In this class, we can have a state something like this. Okay, this is my state object. Okay, and I will have a render function inside it. In this render function, I will be returning something, and that something will be a JSX. Right, in this state you can have count or something like this, count which is initially 0. Okay, and you might have onClick method here which will actually update the count. So this dot update count, you are triggering this particular method. So if you are writing constructor, then you have to bind this method. Otherwise, you can just use arrow function and you can call this method. Update count I will be defining here. So what this function is doing is it is just updating the state. And how we do it, this dot set state, here you can access the previous state, or what you can do is previous state plus one. This was my previous state. And in the previous state, I have a count. Previous state dot count plus one. So we can just return an object. What we can do is based on the previous state. So I have the count. Previous state dot count plus one. This is how we have to return the new state object. This is how we actually write a simple functions, right? We are just updating the, this is the DOM event we are triggering. Now we are using these arrow functions in the DOM event, so we don't need to bind it to this object. But this is typical our class-based component look like. I mean, you might be familiar with this method also, where we used to write a constructor. And here we have to call the parent class constructor by passing the props, and here you can actually do initializing your state with something like count which is 0. So this is another way, I mean this is the earlier way, but you can just directly initialize the state. And here, instead of writing something like this, what we used to do, you can also bind the DOM events like update count. So these are the points which I was talking about, that if you are dealing with a class-based component, you have to, and you are ending up writing a lot of code, right? You are binding to this. Here we are not using, consider that we are not using these arrow functions. This dot update count, you have to bind it, and this is the definition, right? And you are doing a set state. Now this class-based component, if you wanted to convert it into a functional component, what you will do is, okay, I will create this anonymous function, const hello, and this is, here I'm accessing the props if I'm getting anything from the parent component. Okay, here I will not have a render function, I will just return whatever the JSX I want to, because this is the function, it will have only, it will be returning JSX. Okay, here we'll have this method. Now we don't need to use this. You can just directly write const update count. And what you will be doing in the update count, you will be updating the state object, right? Now we are writing functional component. We don't have a set state method. So what you can do is you can use our hooks. Okay, here I'm putting count. Set count, and here use state hook we can use, which will help us to initialize the state with zero. And whenever we say update count, we can say set count. And what we are doing is, if we have the previous count, otherwise what we can do is count plus one. Count is the current state, we are doing plus one. So whatever is the count, we are just increasing that, right? So this is how we write the simple function component, and this is how we can have the same state. Right, the same class-based component can be returned something like this. And this is plain and simple, I think, right? The arrow functions, I have written this arrow function here as an anonymous function. And you can do a lot of things here, like if you want to write a DOM event, we can also talk about it. Here I'm writing React fragment, and like I'm writing input type text field. Input type text here on the on change, I will be doing handle change. Okay, and value for this text field will be, I will have a value as a state. Okay, so I can have this method const value. Set value, and I can use state. Inside use state, what we can do is initialize this value to the empty quotes, I mean the empty value. So initially the text field will show the empty value, but we have a handle change method, so we have to define it. Again, simple arrow function we can write, and here we can access the event object also coming from here. Handle change, and what we can do is set value equal to e dot target dot value. It's plain and simple, right? This is how you are able to update the value, and you can also able to see that, and here you can also print the value which you are updating value, right? I mean, I can run this example, this is very basic. So you can have multiple set of states. It can have an array, object, integer, boolean. You can have the flag also. Like if you wanted to have a boolean state which you wanted to toggle to true or false, like flag. Always remember that you have to use, if you are using the pre-built hook like use state, then you have to put set flag, set count, value set value. And initially this is false, right? But when you start typing something, handle change, I wanted to mark it as a set flag equal to true. Set flag. Now this becomes true, right? So you can just check if e dot target dot value, if it is there, if some value is coming which is not empty, then what you want is you want to make it as a, I mean, you can set both the values. And obviously this is obvious that when user will be typing something, then only the target value will be coming. But sometimes you are removing items, you are removing character from the text field and making this empty, then this will become false. I mean, you can just set it. Set flag is a false because now text field is empty. Just showing you the basic demo how we are actually dealing with the hooks. Okay. I hope this should be useful for you. Now in the next video, we'll start talking about the use state hook. We have already covered little bit about use state hook. You will see what all different use case, what all different type of values use state can use. Like state can be object, boolean, string, array, anything, right? And we are just using this use state hook to initialize the state. And this is the function which will take care of updating the state. So this is the initializer, count is 0. Set count is a function which will set a new state for this count. Okay, thanks everyone.